Good morning to all students. How are you? I hope you all are well. It is our actually second lecture of biology, and here we will discuss about small intestine and those parts actually which are dealing with duodenum and how some of the juices are secreted. Okay. So before to start this small intestine as well as gallbladder and pancreas, I just want to say one thing. Exocrine and endocrine. What is the difference between? Sorry, it is endo, D-O, okay, D-O. Endocrine gland and exocrine gland. Okay. Endocrine glands are those glands which secrete hormones. Okay, endocrine glands secrete hormone, and exocrine glands which secrete juices, and in that juices enzymes are present which are good for digestion. Clear now? Have you got the difference between exocrine gland and endocrine gland? Endocrine glands secrete hormones. Okay, and exocrine gland secretes juices, and this enzymes are present which work on digestive system, which work on digestion. Clear? So this thing you have discussed now. Okay, now come. So students, I was discussing duodenum. Then in duodenum actually small intestine classified into three parts: duodenum, jejunum, as well as ileum. Clear ka? Ileum I have not written. Okay. It is ileum. So today we discussed about actually two glands, that how it secretes some juices and transfer into duodenum. How it goes to duodenum, then we discuss all that small intestine part. Clear? So first we discuss pancreas. Okay. So pancreas actually is an organ, or it is a gland also. Sorry, I'll not use the word organ. It's a gland which is present below the side of stomach. It is a gland which is present below the stomach, actually beneath the stomach. Clear? And it secretes juice as well as hormones. Okay. Okay, beta. It means it is heterocrine gland. It is a gland which is heterocrine in nature. Heterocrine in nature. Again, so I am saying pancreas gland, which is just situated beneath the stomach. It is heterocrine gland. Heterocrine gland means which can secrete exocrine gland as well as endocrine. Both exist. It means it can secrete juices as well as hormones. Clear? So it is a gland which can secrete hormones as well as juices. So it secrete insulin as well as glucagon hormones, and it also secrete pancreatic juice. This thing is clear? I'm just writing also, you can just write down. So it secretes juices as well as hormones. Clear now? Pancreatic juice as well as insulin and glucagon okay, it is a heterokine in nature. It secretes juices as well as hormones. Which juice it secretes? It secretes pancreatic juices. And it secretes insulin as well as glucagon hormone also. Clear? And a hormone, again we will discuss beta this thing, that it secretes two hormones, glucagon hormone as well as insulin hormone. What is the function of insulin? It converts glucose into glycogen. What is the function of insulin? It converts glucose into glycogen. And what is the function of glucagon? It converts glycogen into glucose. Again, I am saying, any actually person which has enough glucose, so insulin work on that, and insulin convert this glucose into glycogen. Now suppose any actually person which has a deficiency of glucose, so in that case glucagon work and it convert glycogen into glucose. This thing is clear now. Glucagon actually present in alpha cells, and insulin present in beta cells. Remember, these are present from in cells, alpha cells and beta cells. Alpha cells, glucagon present in alpha cells, and as well as this insulin present in beta cells. Remember this. But right now I have to discuss digestive parts, so concentrate in that part. So pancreas secrete pancreatic juices. In that, so many enzymes are present. So first let me discuss what are the actually enzymes which are present in the pancreatic juices, then I will tell you the function also. So first write down just the which are the enzymes which are present in pancreatic juice. Okay, so these are amylase, lipase, trypsin, chemotrypsin, okay, carboxy. Carboxy dipeptidase. So these are the actual enzymes which are present in these pancreatic juices. Okay, I'll tell you the function also. But I'm just telling these are the enzymes which are present in a pancreatic juices. Clear? Okay. So first I have told pancreatic, it is just present beneath the stomach. Then I have told it secretes both things. Then pancreatic juices, in this enzymes are present. These are the enzymes which are present on that. And remember student, these pancreatic actually juices work on fat, carbohydrate as well as protein. Okay. So pancreatic juices work on these three components, fat actually as well as carbohydrate and protein. So these enzymes convert fat into fatty acids, small components, clear, protein into amino acids. First it is converted into actual peptides, and then it is converted into last amino acids. So you can say these enzymes convert protein into amino acids. Clear? So these are the some function, and at last these converts carbohydrate into glucose. Clear? So these are the function of enzymes also. So write down the last part. Okay. So these enzymes convert fat into fatty acids, protein into amino acids, and carbohydrate into glucose. Clear? You have to write down this part. Actually, space is not enough now. That's why I'm not able to write. So just write down this actually sentence. Clear? Shall I just remove? will discuss next gland. Remember students, pancreas is the second largest gland, huh? And liver is the largest gland in a body. Okay, first largest. Clear now? So if I just discuss a liver, so it is in this form actually. You can see, and it is bilobed. It is bilobed, having two lobes, beta, left and right, but right part is broader. Right part is broader, remember. Okay, and just below side, gallbladder is present. Below side, gallbladder is present. Here also I just mentioned it is a gallbladder. Okay, so first beta, liver actually, it is bilobed, and these lobes having so many lobules. We can say millions of lobules, okay, and that millions of lobules are present. Clear? So it has millions of lobules, but remember that right part of that lobe is broader as compared to left part. And what is the function? Again, I just classified these lobes are further classified into millions of lobules. And these lobules, beta, actually form bile juice. It make bile juice. And all that bile juice actually is stored at this gallbladder. Remember. Okay. I am saying all the lobules, okay, na, are form bile juice, and these bile juice is stored in a gallbladder. Clear? And through these hepatic, because suppose it is a gallbladder, na beta. Okay? So along with, I just want to show a diagram. So easily we can just know how it is mixed. These one nerve is coming. And suppose it is a pancreas, and C-shaped duodenum is there. C-shaped duodenum. Okay. So here pancreas duct is there. It is pancreas duct. With this hepatic duct, with this hepatic duct, it forms a common part. This common duct is known as hepatic pancreatic common duct. Okay? So I am saying, just see, beta. From this, hepatic duct is there, okay now, this is pancreatic duct is there, it is hepatic, okay, from this side, hepatic duct, from this side, pancreatic duct, both will form a common actually duct, okay, and it is linked with duodenum, it is linked with duodenum, so it is a duodenum which is C in shape, na beta. So both form a common duct, and from pancreatic duct, pancreatic juices are there, and in a hepatic duct, bile juice actually are present. Clear? And form a common duct, which is linked with duodenum. Clear? And who controls the exit of this hepatic duct, beta? Because it is also fixed now that how many juices, how, what is the amount of juice which will enter in a duodenum, it should be fixed or not. Okay now, so it is controlled by a sphincter of Oddi. So beta, suppose it is a just let me mention clearly, beta, because it is not visible. It form a common duct, just like this. Both are common, huh? And suppose it is a duodenum. Okay, so it is a sphincter here. Sphincter of Oddi, name is sphincter of Oddi, which control the juice or bile juice, probably we can say combined, which control all the juices, that how amount of juice will enter into this duodenum. Okay, so it is controlled by sphincter of Oddi. Do you know the function of actually sphincter? It controls the entry as well as exit of particles or not. So which will control? Sphincter of Oddi will control. Is it clear? Again I am just revising, beta. It is a hepatic duct in which bile juice is coming. Next, pancreatic duct. It is a pancreatic duct through which pancreatic juice is coming. Both will fuse and form a common duct. Okay, its other name is hepatic pancreatic duct. And this duct in which juices are present, this juice is controlled by sphincter of Oddi. Clear now? Okay, so just mention all this part. Now, beta, all the juice will enter into duodenum, remember, huh? That pancreatic juice, bile juice, all will enter at which part? Duodenum. Now discuss what is the function of bile juice. Okay, what is the function of bile juice? Its first function, beta, its first function is, suppose if a undigested food, or then partially digested food, if a partially digested food is acidic in nature, so first it reduces or removes the acidity. Okay, it made it actually alkaline in nature. So, okay, so bile juice convert actually acidic nature into basic nature. Clear now? So bile juice remove the acidity nature of particles. Clear or not? And second thing, you already know, it converts fat into simpler form. Okay, it converts fat into smaller particles. Clear? And this phenomena is known as emulsification of fat. Okay, beta. So emulsification of fat means conversion of fat into smaller components. Clear? What is mean by emulsification of fat? Conversion of fat into smaller components. So it has two functions. First, remove the acidity nature of particles, because first, remember, beta, suppose if these food particles enter into duodenum, na, so directly these enzymes which are present in pancreas, na, cannot attack and convert into simpler form. So first it is required that this acidity, this acidic nature should be removed. Okay, so first this bile juice remove the acidity, remove the acidic nature and convert it into alkaline. Okay, beta, convert into basic, then all that enzymes work on that. And remember, bile juice also convert that fat into smaller components, fatty acids. This thing is clear now? So function of bile juice is clear. How actually it is enter, it is clear now, beta. Okay, now I'll just tell you some of the enzymes. Okay, that how it functions and convert into which part. Clear? Up to this it is clear or not? Okay. So these are the things. First, amylase beta. Amylase actually convert starch into maltose. Lipase convert fat into fatty acids. Trypsin convert protein into peptide. Okay, chemotrypsin again convert protein into peptides. Okay, now these peptides again, where to write, I don't know. Okay, there I'm just trying to write. These peptides again converted into amino acids through carboxypeptide base. Okay, let me clear the actual spelling. Okay, it is clear. Peptide base. Okay, so first protein converted into peptides, then peptides converted into amino acids. Maltase, maltose converted into glucose. Lactose converted into glucose, and here sucrose converted into glucose. Okay, so these are the some of the enzymes. Just write down, maybe two or three actually enzymes remaining. If I just missed, I'll tell you. And actually WhatsApp group also. So these are some enzymes which work on these things and convert it into simpler form. What is the function of bile salt? Converts fat into fatty acids. Remember this, huh? So just copy beta. These are the functions of enzymes and how it convert it into simpler form. I'm just removing. Now students, we have discussed all that part. Now discuss that how a small intestine, because now juices are entered or not. Now we discuss a small intestine. It is classified into three parts: duodenum, next jejunum, as well as last genius. Let us discuss first its size actually. Okay, its size is near about 7 मीटर और 21 फीट. ओके इट्स साइज नियर अबाउट 21 फीट बेटा. ओके एंड फर्स्ट ऑलरेडी यू इन अ ड्यूडेनम एक्चुअली डाइजेशन विल स्टार्ट एंड जूसेस सेक्रेटेड. ओके बट इन जेजुनम बोथ एब्जॉर्प्शन as well as digestion both occurs. Clear na? In a jejunum beta absorption as well as digestion both occurs. Remember it is an important question from which part absorption starts. From a jejunum part absorption starts. In the duodenum beta it is not start here only digestion takes place beta. Here only digestion takes place. You have to remember. And remember beta, suppose food is converted into simpler form. Okay. Digestion is going on. But at the last part till last part, all that food components converted into simpler form. So in that ileum part, all that vitamins and everything is converted into simpler form because it is the part through which all that food components are converted into simpler form except some of water or minerals which is entered into cecum. So remember, ileum is the part where all food components including minerals and vitamins converted into simpler form and after that it is absorbed through villus. How it actually become absorbed? With the help of microvilli. Clear? So through microvilli, all that small particles absorbed. Clear? So at last there minerals and salts also absorb. Clear? This thing is clear or not? Okay. For that, we have discussed today with small intestine up to ileum part. Okay. And what is that gland? What is the function of pancreatic juices? What is the function of hormones? What is the difference between exocrine and exocrine? Okay. And at last, we have discussed that in ileum, all that food components converted into simpler form. So for today, it is more than enough. Now we discuss next large intestine and the rest part on tomorrow. Thank you so much.